A very good morning to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial we will show you that how you can create this Opera logo reveal animation in PowerPoint. However, this tutorial is not just about how to create this Opera logo reveal animation. Instead, I will try to explain you a few techniques that you can use for other animations as well, or you can understand how the animation effects behave and how the transition behave in PowerPoint. So I have created this animation using two different techniques. On the first slide, if I show you the animation pan by clicking on the animations tab, then animation pan, then you can see all the animation effects that I had applied to create this animation. From the second slide, we used a different technique, and for that we have to create five same animation in using the five different slides. Whereas using the first technique, using the PowerPoint animation effect, we created the entire scene on a single slide. From the third slide, we are using the morph transition, as you can see here. So basically you can create this animation using two different techniques. The first one is using the PowerPoint animation effect, and second one is using the morph transition. So that way you may better understand that how morph transition behave and what are the limitations of morph transition and what are the advantages of using the PowerPoint animation effect, and which one is easy, and you can decide that later on after watching this entire video. So before we begin, I would also like to open the selection pan here so you can see all the objects that we used on this first slide. So basically we have five ovals, the main ovals that you will see in the beginning of the animation, and then we have this entire logo which is a part of three different objects. If I show you 1, 2, and 3, let me undo this. And if I show you the list of animations, then you can see here we have used a very different kind of animations to create this entire scene. So when the animation will begin, first of all these five main ovals will appear. And if you see the animation pan, then you can see that we have used the circle animation for all these five ovals. So to select more than one animation in the animation pan, you can select the first one, then hold down the shift key and then click on the next one up to which you want to select all the animation effects. And if you want to make a non-continuous selection, then you can hold down the control key. Now right click on these animation effect, choose effect option properties, and I am using circle animation effect with the direction to out. So you can also experiment with other animation effects, like you can also use fade animation effect for that as well. Now you can see the changes here. So instead of fade, if you want to apply the fade animation effect, then I will advise to you to increase the duration of the animation so that they appear very slowly. So, or you can also use the basic zoom entrance effect. So if you want to change the animation of the selected objects here like this, I want to change all these five animation effects. So after selecting all of them, you should always change the animation effect from this list instead of going to the add animation. That way they will replace the existing animation. Like if I click on the wipe, then they will change to the wipe animation effect, all of them, as you can see here. Or if I go to the add animation and then I click on any other animation, let's say wheel, then you can see that it added five more animation effect into the animation pan, whereas the previous are inact. So I will delete all of them by selecting the first one, hold down the shift key, select the last one and hit the delete key. So the next thing is, let me open the selection pan and let me hide all of them. Now I will just make one of the oval appear on the slide, let's say this one. Here in the animation pan you can see all the animation effects that we have applied to oval 1, and we have used similar animation effects for rest of the ovals. So basically what we are doing here, that we are moving this oval to the left and then again reversing back to its original position, and then combining them, all these three ovals, first three ovals, to the right two ovals, and then after combining they create one oval and then the logo appears. So to move this oval to the left and have a bit, little bit delay between the auto reverse, so there is no option. As you can see here, the oval appears, and for appear we change that to the wipe. First we were using the circle animation without traction. So if I want to change it back to circle, I click here and go to more entrance effect, and here I choose circle, and under effect options I choose out, set to play with previous, and a duration of, let's say, half a second. So that was the first animation effect, and to move it to the left side we use the left motion path. But the problem here is, if I make a check mark on auto reverse, then the oval 1 will move to left and will immediately reverse back to its original position, whereas we need a little bit delay between the reverse. So you can't do that using a single animation path. Like if you move it to left and make a check mark on auto reverse, then after completing the duration of the animation effect, it will immediately turn back. Whereas in the animation preview, you have seen that they move to the left and stay there for half a second and then change their position back to the right. So to make this delay, what we have to do, we have to define different motion paths. Like if you want to move it to the left first, then you first will apply add motion path, and here you will choose the left motion path and will adjust the length, that how much movement you want to give to this animation effect, like up to this position. And to make a delay between the reverse, let's say if I set it to play with previous and a duration of 1 second, and if I want to move it back to its original position but after half a second delay, then what I have to do, I have to go to add animation again, more motion path, and this time I will choose the right motion path. And here, what is the technique you have to use? That you have to move the starting point to the end point, and then you have to move the start position to the end position of the last animation. Okay, set it to play with previous, change the duration, and here you can add as much delay timing between both of the animation as you want. Like I want to reverse it back after 4 seconds. So let's say I delete all of these for the time and show you how it will behave. So what we want, for that we have to apply different motion paths again and again until you need to move it to the exact location where you want it. So that what we did for all the other ovals as well. Let me show you all of the objects on the slide. So if you have noticed in the animation preview that the 3 ovals move to the left and 2 move to the right, but they also grow in the size, and for that we have applied the grow shrink animation effect with 150% growth rate, and we are using a very short duration for this animation effect, half a second, and we are not repeating it. And to make these ovals transparent and back to normal, we have to use 2 different techniques. And when you go to the more fill color, here you can see on the first place we have applied a 50% transparency to these ovals. And then when the animation starts, then you can see that we are using here the transparency animation effect for the oval 1. And later, after appearing, then moving to the left, increasing in size, it will change its transparency. And for that we have used the add animation effect, emphasis effect, and here you can find this transparency animation effect from where you can increase or decrease the transparency level. So as here we have applied the 50% transparency for this, and you can see the same here for oval 3 and oval 2 and oval 5. You can see that we have used the same animation effects, and here you will see that we have again used the motion path, but this time we are using right motion path, and you can see the delay timing difference between these animation effects. So here the oval 1 will move to the left, will stay there, and then after half a second delay between the left move and to the right move back, here is the duration timing that you can notice. And we are doing this for all the ovals. So if I move below, then here if I open the transparency, there here you can see that I have reduced the transparency level to the 0% to make the ovals filled with the exact color. So we repeated all the same animation effect on all the ovals to change their position to the left and back to the right while increasing in size and changing the transparency level. That is what we did on all these ovals. And when we don't require an oval on the slide anymore, then for that we are using the disappear animation effect. So that way we created this entire animation on a single slide. Whereas that is very much complicated method. If you ask me, then I will say that defining the motion path, the very short, if the length of the motion path are very short, then it is really a headache in PowerPoint to adjust the length of the motion path. And along with that, it is also very much difficult to remember that how much length you want to give to each of the oval. For the right to left position and then back left to right position. So that method is a little bit complicated, whereas Morph Transition makes it very easy. And that is what we have done on rest of these five slides. We created the same animation using the Morph Transition. So to make it easy, let me delete this one. So on the very first slide that you can see that we are using the circle animation, the same animation effect to make the oval appear. So let me remove this after timing and choose on mouse click, and let me set this for all these slides. And for that I will select the second one, hold down the shift key, will select the last one and will make a check mark on mouse click. So let me show you the slideshow, and you should also notice that on the first slide we are not using any transitions. So when I will see the slideshow, all these five circles will appear with the circle animation effect with outer traction. Okay, that's what we want. And on the second slide, what we did, we just changed the position like this by just holding, dragging and dropping. We changed the position and we also changed the transparency level from the more fill color. And here I added the 50% transparency on the second slide. And we did this for all these five ovals, change the position and change the transparency level. On the second slide, as you can see here, we have used the Morph Transition, that's it, and with the duration timing of half a second. On the third slide we have again changed the position of these ovals, and now they are appearing just as two ovals, and we again change the transparency level back to 0%. Now on the fourth slide, and on the third slide we are also using the Morph Transition, and on the fourth slide we again change the position and change the transparency level, and on the last slide we removed all the rest of the ovals and making these one appear. And for that we are again using the fade animation effect for these three different objects. As I have shown you before, they are three different objects, and we don't require these oval. They will automatically get disappear when these objects will appear on top of it, or either you can also use the disappear animation effect. So if I show you the slideshow, and that is what we have to did to create the same animation effects using the Morph Transition, and I think that one is the easy. Now when I will click, it will move to the second slide with the Morph Transition, and now the third slide, fourth slide and then fifth slide. So before ending this lesson, I will also like to tell you one thing about the Morph Transition, and that is, I think it's the drawback of the Morph Transition. So let's say on the third slide we go to the animations and add a animation, let's say fly in, and start it with previous. So it should start without any delay when the slideshow will move to the third slide. But here you should notice one thing, that the fly in animation effect will work after the Morph Transition. So let me show you the slideshow once again. And so when it moves to the third slide, the red ovals fly in from the bottom, but after the Morph Transition. So that is what my point is, that if you are using the Morph Transition and also applying some animation effect to the objects, then you should remember one thing, that all the animation effects will work after the Morph Transition will end. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.